this example, we're factoring a very basic trinomial. And when you're factoring a trinomial, you're breaking it apart by looking at the numbers that they give you. So we want something that multiplies to get the constant and that adds together to get the middle term. So you're going to start thinking about the constant and listing the factors, like what multiplies together to give you that negative 21. Well, you could do 1 and negative 21, or negative 1 and 21, or you could do positives and negatives with the 3 and a 7. You look at your list and see which of those is going to add together to get that middle term, that negative 4. And it looks like the positive 3 and the negative 7, because 3 plus negative 7 is negative 4. So hang on to that information. I'm going to write the problem over again. And we're going to open up a double bubble. We're actually breaking it apart into two factors here. The x is going to divide itself up and become an x in each of the bubbles. So that would multiply together to give you the x squared. And then you're going to use the 3 and the negative 7 that you identified in the rest of the factors. So you've got x plus 3 and x minus 7, and that is your final answer for this one. Let's look at one more. In this case, same thing. You're looking for something that's going to multiply to get the constant, and it's going to add together to get the middle term. Don't forget, when you list the factors of the constant, that even though it's negative 3, there is still always the 1 times 3 combinations. And in this case, the 1 and the negative 3 are going to add together to give you the negative 2 that you need. So write your expression out, open your double bubble, break your x apart, and add those two factors that you found inside the bubbles. So your final answer on this one is x plus 1, x minus 3.